Delusional experiments and my own devotion to pure science. Which leads us directly to the subject of today's lecture. The brain. There is nothing like the brain. Hearts and lungs are simply tinker toys stacked against the brain. I've nothing against the womb. I thank the bladder when I'm excreting, and I always give the elbow room. But the brain, please allow me to explain. There's no organ can compare to it. I swear to it, it's plain. It's the brain, Mr. Hilltop. Mr. Hilltop here, with whom I have never worked nor given any prior instruction to, has graciously offered his services for today's demonstration.
Sir?
Yes?
I'm not sure I understand the difference between voluntary and reflex nerve impulses.
Very good. Since our lab work today is a demonstration of just that distinction. Ms. Medulla oblongata tells us Brainstem that it's got a synonym pulse full of data which creates a lot of pain. His frontal lobe gets busy with a thought that makes him dizzy, since his cortex in a tizzy, so he never will complain. That's what I love. Please. You have just witnessed a voluntary nerve impulse, Mr. Hilltop, you may lower your knee. Reflex movements, on the other hand, are those which are made independently of the will. Why, you dirty, rotten, yellow son of a bitch! Even though I almost need him, his reflexes have no freedom to react when I mistreat him. It's important I explain. Synaptic nerve connection goes its way without detection, bringing cranial protection and a never-ending chain. That's what I love about the brain. But what if we were to block those nerve impulses by simply applying local pressure, which can be done with any ordinary metal clamp just at the swelling of the posterior nerve root for, let's say, 4 seconds? Why, you mother-grabbing bastard! As you can see, even though I have just shoved my knee into his crotch, he does not react. He feels absolutely nothing. More or less. So, if it were not for this continuous stream of motor impulses from the brain, we would collapse like a bunch of broccoli. And in conclusion, so there's no confusion, let me say it once again. Though your genitalia has been known to fail, yeah, you can bet your ass on the brain. Everybody! Call me a Darwinella, that means theory. Call me Master and Watts, we get teary. Damn, I'm curious, that would be the best. Call me a Rush, I come up to the test. I really like it when you call me Edison. Call me an Illic, I love that medicine. Call me Ricardi, that wild as well. Call me Pop, and I drop like a chop. Call me a Max, I'm not really fine. You can call me a Tesla, I would decline. Would you call me a Frankenstein, would be insane. Transylvania.
grandfather, Dr. Victor von Frankenstein, has passed away and died.
Oh no.
Oh yes. It is imperative that you come here to his castle at once.
Oh no.
Oh yes. You must come or else your entire estate will be seized by the Transylvania Tax Authority.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh, thank you. Here's a dime.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Goodbye, Dr. Frankenstein!
Frankenstein!
Does that mean you love me?
Oh, you bet your boots it does, mister!
Oh, Elizabeth! Oh, the love of my life!
Oh, nails!
What?
The nails, darling! I'm sorry, they take 3 months to dry! Oh, thank you, darling! Hey, you.
Hey.
I know somebody likes old-fashioned weddings.
I prefer old-fashioned wedding night.
Darling, you're comfortable!
I promise not to step a step closer.
Thank you, darling.
I can still dream, can't I?
Dream all you want, my darling, of every lustful situation. Those naughty thoughts are fine with me, as long as they stay locked away in your
Transylvania Station?
Yeah, yeah! Truck 59! Can I give you a shine?
Oh, no thanks, I'm wearing suede.
Thank you. way. And we'll be off for Castle Frankenstein, where I will work humbly at your side as you navigate the seams of a snow-rigged
city. Damn it, Igor! How many times do I have to tell you? I have absolutely no interest in continuing my grandfather's wacky work.
Really? I can went so far as to hire a local girl, Inga, to assist you in your wacky work.
Well, you shouldn't have, because I will have absolutely no use for a local girl.
How do you do?
I have a master's degree in laboratory science from Heidelberg Junior College. I can fulfill all your needs. I'm a very hard worker, and if necessary, I'll even bend over backwards for you.
What do you say, Doc? Shall I fire her?
I'd like to sleep on it.
Oh, I mean, think about it. Oh, by the way, how are we getting to the castle?
A wee stroll further.
Dr. Frankenstein!
Stay!
I'm your housekeeper, Frau Blücher.
How do you do?
And who, may I ask, is this lovely young creature?
She's my new laboratory assistant, Inga.
Oh, thank you, doctor. Assistant, huh? So that's what they're calling them these days. How do you do?
Inga, may I present Frau Blücher?
All is in readiness for your arrival, Herr Doctor. If you will follow me, stay close to the guns. The staircase can be threatened.
After you, Frau Blücher. Now I believe I will remain down here and read for a little while.
As you wish, Dr. Frankenstein.
That's Frankenstein! Will you please try and get my monster from?
Stay, yes. I will never forget.
Stay!
Your grandfather, Victor, also often liked to stay up late. Read.
Is that his portrait?
Yeah, that is Victor.
Handsome.
Yeah, very awesome.
By the way, these books, they all seem rather general. Heidi, Black Beauty, the Kama Sutra. Where are my grandfather's medical books? His private library.
I don't know what you mean, Herr Doctor.
Never mind, I will retire on my own. Good night.
The doctor care for a brandy while he is reading?
No, thank you.
Some bone milk, perhaps?
Nothing. Thank you, that's very kind of me.
Oh, what thing?
Nothing! I said nothing! Nothing means nothing!
Then I will say good night.
Good night, Frau Blücher! It was from the crust of a heather-covered hillside that young Rebecca first set eyes on Sunnybrook Farms. Who are you? What do you want?
I am your grandfather.
Follow in our footsteps and you'll be eternal fame.
a Frankenstein! I'm not a Frankenstein! Mike, what is it?
You were having a nightmare.
A nightmare? Oh, it was! It was so terrible! Oh, my ancestors, they were so crazy! Oh, they were so crazy, but boy, did they dance! What is that strange music? It seems to be coming from behind this bookcase! Where is it?
There is that!
The device. In every cheapo horror movie, there's always some sort of a device. A triggering mechanism. Oh, come on. Oh! Aha! Nothing. No. No, hand me that candle, will you? Whoa! Put the candle back! Alright, I think I figured it out. You take out the candle, and I'll try and block the bookcase with my body. Oh, now I'll wait. Now I want you to listen very carefully. Do not put the candle back. With all of your might, shove the other side of the bookcase. Now, is that clear?
I think so.
Boyfriend?
Yes!
came to realize that creating life after death would be difficult, but with a bit of luck, I could make it work. Preposterous! Of bestowing animation upon lifeless matter. It could work!
It could, and it must. And you are the only man alive who can hunt you all aboard the
the White Garden.
Doctor?
Oh, I don't know. Am I really going to attempt it? Yes, I am. First things first, Igor. We have got to find a brain of someone who is good and kind, a brilliant mind but sane. I want you to find me the brain of the late Hans Delbert, one of Europe's greatest thinkers, a scholar and a saint.
I know exactly where to find it, Master.
Good. And once we have the brain, what is it, my brain called the roaches? As the tiniest of human hearts were a great hindrance to the speed of my work, I decided therefore to make the creature of a gigantic stature. Of course, that would simplify everything.
His feet, his hands, his organs would all have to be of an enormous size.
Exactly.
He would have an enormous fan scooper.
That goes without saying.
He's going to be very popular.
So, we'll need a body about 7 feet tall, 4 foot wide, newly dead and with all its vital organs still intact. How, where could we ever find such a gigantic corpse?
Trust in me, Master.
You know what I mean.
Yeah. hump.
Your hump? Wasn't it on the right side? Never mind. So, let us now proceed to attempt one of the most daring and radical experiments in the history of medical science. Start directly above us. We must hurry to your stations.
He's alive! He's alive! He's alive! I am free again!
Don't worry. We are your friends. Is the sedative ready?
Yes, doctor.
That's good. Now, do you want us to set you free?
Mm-hmm.
All right. We are going to set you free.
I got nerves about this. Are you nervous about this? Oh, I got nerves about this.
Now, I want you to sit up. Great. Now, stand on your 2 feet. Oh, come on, you can do it. Don't try to kid a kidder. Come on. You can do it. All right. Excellent. Now, walk. Oh, he's doing it. He's doing it.
Thank you. So, I am feeling a bit of a chill out here tonight. May be coming?
No.
Why not?
Because it is the maid's day off in the castle is a frightful.
It's a frightful business!
What was that?
What was that? I didn't hear anything.
I definitely heard something.
There you go. The monsters awake. You must come up with some sort of diversion and quick before he.
And all that other schmarr. Are you ready for what's been going on? Hey, that music makes you woozy. It's the new phenomenon. I've heard about the mania, if not then the meeting lady.
Yeah! right as rain. Oh, but I can't stop thinking about it. Not while that rampaging monster is on the loose. I can't concentrate. Oh, I can't, I can't, I can't!
Sindut, Sindut, Sindut!
You are the most greatest expert on the rain. But there are times, my darling doctor, when your brain should be the last thing on your mind. Let's forget about sinking. Sinking's never smart. Flush your brain, write down the drain, and listen to your heart. Let's be a couple of dumbbells. Dumb life wants a start. Lose your mind, cause love is blind, and listen to your heart. Let's be stupid.
Yeah. it's arranged. A nice surprise.
For love is in the air.
Elizabeth,
what?
It's imperative I must go.
But
Ingo, Igor, let's go catch a monster.
Freddy, Tony, where are you going?
I'm sorry, I didn't get that. Oh, forgive me, I didn't realize you were a mute. An incredibly large mute. Oh, but come in out of the cold. I've lived here for so many years that, even though blind, I've got it like the back of my hand. Oh, you must be hungry. Come to the table. Make yourself comfortable. Sit here. Or maybe here. Oh, there's a nice hot bowl of chicken noodle soup sometime. Oh, was that hold the noodles? Here we go. Nice hot boiling soup. Hold out your bowl. More? You really like it, I can tell. And now, an after-dinner surprise. I've been saving this
special bottle of
Chianti for such a joyous occasion. Hold out your glass. Oh, wait! Don't drink yet. First, we have to toast to our wonderful new friendship. To us! I know, isn't that delicious? And now another surprise. Cigars, here you go. Don't be afraid. Fire is good. Fire is very good. Fire is our friend. See, now you have your cigar. Now let me light it for you. So you hold it out just like that. And don't inhale till the tip glows.
Your strength?
Do you want to talk about physical muscle? The Olympian ideal? Well, you're an Atlas. You're an Adonis. You're a god! Listen to me. You are not that. You are good! You're a primitive soul. You don't know your left from your right. You're lost in the dark. You need a spark to lead you into the light. I'll be that guide. I'll be by your side. I'll pull you out of the mire. You'll be the greatest creation in the land since the invention of fire. You will walk. You will talk. Everybody will gawk at the man about town. From the start, you'll be smart. You will break every heart. You're the man about town. And I know when you open that door, you'll be cheered, never feared before. Raise your eyes to the sky. There's no holding you down. You won't be a flash in the pan. You're the man.
Well said, Freddy! We're engaged! Look at it!
Thank you, Elizabeth!
Isn't it nice?
May I present for your intellectual and philosophical pleasure the creature! Please, remain in your seat, I beg of you. I assure you, there is nothing to be afraid of. First, may I offer for your consideration a neurological demonstration of the primary cerebellar functions, balance and coordination. Walk, heel to toe.
Dressed up like a million dollars. Woof!
Transference? Is it dangerous?
Shh.
Who knows, it's never been done before, but frankly, one or both of us could die.
Oh no! Then why are you doing it?
Oh, because I must. For him. Because I know of no other way I can save him. All right, I'm ready to begin.
Good luck, Moshka!
Thank you, Igor. Wait a minute! Wasn't your hump on the left?
What hump?
Let's get to work! Lower the electrostatic brain transmitters.
Yeah, Doctor! Lowering!
Now, connect the brain transmitters to the endopsychic interchanger.
Yes, Moshka! Connecting!
Inga. Should something happen, should something go wrong, I want you to know I have this feeling. I have a feeling of...
Doctor, the feeling is much... Sorry, a bit premature.
We must hurry. Igor, throw the third switch.
But what happened to the first and second switch?
We have no time. Throw the third switch on the devil.
Thank you.
but...
Wait, no! No! I can't bear to kill you! No! No! No!
Stop! Stand back!
It's the monster! He's alive!
Sometimes, a perchance, a brushstroke of hope, or a wisp of mystic fate can awaken a sleeping heart.
Am I crazy?
What is going on here?
Less than an hour ago, he was a dead monster, a walking beast. And now he's alive and talking like no coward.
It's because of him. Half-crazed genius that he is. Not only risked his own life to save mine, but give me the power of speech and a brilliant mind.
But that makes no sense!
Oh, it is because of the transference. Everything that was in the doctor's brain is now in the monster's brain.
You saved me. How can I ever thank you?
Nay, his eye should thank you for the humanity that you have given me. I can now live a rich and full life and perhaps do good for all of those I've come to know.
Everyone! Everyone! Listen to him! Listen to him! I did it! I did it! All my strength for it! Watch him on madly!
Campus alive!
But not for long!
What?
Strings and both of them! They are both responsible for the death of Elizabeth Bennet. Disappointed. They're all disappointed, but nonetheless, you're free to go, dear doctor.
Thank you. Thank you.
And you too, M-Star.
Oh, darling! Were those dreadful men going to hurt you?
Darling? Did you just call him darling?
Frederick, I realize you have a shabby thing for Jack to do to his creator, but I'm afraid that I've fallen madly in love with your fiancé.
Not with him!
Deep love, at last she's found deep love. Been searching for deep love.
To the Transylvania, perhaps to purchase a castle like this one.
I'm sorry, sir, but this castle is not for sale. It belongs to me, and I'll be living in it from now on because I'm going to join the family business, learn the family trade, make another monster, make the world afraid. We can take a hayride when we're off.
Whoa!